You are negative. Such a comforting thing to hear these days. But then, not always. One day, a husband and wife had an argument where some nasty words were exchanged. Late in the day, when the husband reached his office, he messaged his wife, "You are negative." The wife messaged back, "You are arrogant, you are selfish, and you are dominating." The husband messaged back, "I was referring to the medical test you did yesterday. You are negative."
For those who are troubled, for those for whom family is everything, for those who seek guidance on family matters, and for those for whom family matters. Here in Atmadarshan, we bring to you Atmadarshan's YouTube FM, Family Matters.
Human interaction suggests that we are quick to be negative, to criticize, to point out faults, to keep a record of wrongs, to react, and to look out for opportunities to hit out. And we are slow to be positive, appreciating others, looking at the brighter side of life, and finding the good in others. These leaves us more negative than positive. The statement then, "You are negative," can therefore be applied to us all. So how does this negativity affect our daily life? First of all, we start using inferior material to build our families and our communities. As an example, let's take rice, our staple food. Imagine one day the rice is not cooked properly. We now have a choice to rant and rave about the badly cooked rice, or we have a choice to see it as a one-off thing and that besides rice, there are other things that are cooked or done properly. We can then confirm our families and our communities on what goes wrong or on what goes right, the positive or the negative, the good or the bad. Rice here is just used as a metaphor. But then it makes clear that we often use bad rice over the many other good things to build our families and communities. Secondly, besides using inferior material, we'll be contributing towards a general negative mindset. Imagine a family where the members are quick to notice the negative and slow to notice the positive. That family will obviously display a collective negative mindset, thus being very unhelpful to each other. In such a family atmosphere, growth, creativity, enthusiasm, and living joyfully will be difficult to foster. It's important, therefore, to change. How do we do that? Two simple strategies. The first, we learn to see the best in others. The other may be our spouse, our child, our parent, our brother or sister. Studies on positive people show how the positive in them was noticed and affirmed consistently. People then tend to take their goodness seriously. On the other hand, constant criticism, constant harping on the negative, constant pointing out of mistakes can often lead people to believe all the negative that is said to them. What's even more worse is, negativity can be contagious. Frequent negativity between the husband and wife can have a negative effect on the child. A child exposed to regular shouting and arguments between his parents will begin to see the world in the language, mindset, and behaviors of his parents. Criminals often come from backgrounds where they've been exposed to too much negativity. It's important, therefore, to learn to see the best in the members of your family, your neighbors, your community, and to affirm what is best in them. Secondly, and more importantly, we need to learn to see the best in ourselves. I won't be off the mark if I say we do have a self-esteem crisis amongst us. There are so many of us who fail to appreciate ourselves. So many who feel inferior. So many of us constantly comparing self to others and putting ourselves down. Added to this is today's popular culture, which thrives on making people feel inferior and then tries to hook them onto video games, shopping, internet browsing, and social media to make them feel good about themselves. Unfortunately, popular culture is designed to just take us on the merry-go-round, but not forward or higher. Sir Edmund Hillary, the first man along with Tenzing Norgay to reach the summit of Everest, used to say, "It's not the mountain we conquer, but ourselves." Conquering our own negativity and discovering the goodness and positiveness can work wonders both for ourselves and the people we live with. The simple words of Jesus, "Love one another as you love yourself," contain a profound truth that unless we esteem ourselves, unless we are positive about ourselves, unless we find goodness in us, we may not discover love, goodness, and positivity around us. This we may be able to foster when keeping medical tests aside. Others can truly say this about us: you are positive.